And next, a controversial stance in education, a guarantee that all students leaving third grade are able to read, and a commitment to hold back those who can't. 14 states have adopted these so-called retention rules, while others are considering such legislation this year. Special correspondent John Tulenko of Learning Matters reports from Ohio.
You're gonna like the way you look. I guarantee it.
The Travelocity Guarantee.
And the Chevy Love It or Return It Guarantee.
Lots of products come with guarantees.
You're not gonna pay a lot.
I guarantee it.
What if schools could make guarantees too? In Ohio, they do. New legislation guarantees that all third graders will read at grade level by the end of the year. Right now, 30%, some 40,000 students, are not. Linda Hissett teaches third grade in Cincinnati.
I have some students who are at a kindergarten level reading, first grade level reading, second grade. I look at it with dismay.
Ms. Hissett is no fan of promoting children before they're ready. She first saw the effects when she taught fifth grade.
Their whole day is made harder because all of our texts are based upon a fifth grade reading speed. Math class is harder because you're having word problems, science, social studies. So for them to be sitting in a class that is too hard for them, it's making their education more of a challenge and an obstacle.
Ohio's remedy? Hold those students back. A third grader who cannot read by the end of the year will not move on.
The third grade reading guarantee is going to the very heart of education, and that's the ability to read.
State Senator Peggy Lehner introduced the guarantee.
Up until third grade, you're learning to read. After third grade, you're reading to learn. That if you aren't well-equipped, reading proficiently at the end of third grade, you're going to struggle throughout the rest of your school years.
How are they different?
Holding the line at third grade is catching on. 14 states have adopted retention policies, six since 2010.
But it's controversial. Studies suggest repeating a grade doesn't pay off and may actually result in higher dropout rates down the line, potentially devastating news for disadvantaged minority students. They're already five times as likely to be held back. Still, for states fed up with schools that fail to teach students to read, tough love approaches like Ohio's are just about guaranteed to deliver a powerful message.
Everybody was shocked. The first thing that came out of everybody's mouth was, oh my God. Okay, how are we gonna do this?
The promise to hold students back has put enormous pressure on principals like Ruthie Jackson of Carson Elementary in Cincinnati.
The third grade guarantee. It's a buzzword for the whole school and also the whole district. That's all we're gonna be talking about this year.
Roughly half her students in grades K through 3 read below grade level.
We've got to buckle down and they gotta read. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it.
I will say the word and you say all the sounds in the word.
Right away, Carson and most other schools rushed out and hired reading specialists. They've been scrambling to test every student in grades K through 3.
We're taking it extremely seriously. I mean, it is urgent. Song. The most severe cases, we need to back way up and teach them their basic phonics and things like that.
A dog sniffed.
To provide more one-on-one help, the school is asking classroom teachers to tutor struggling readers. High school volunteers have been recruited as well, but all these efforts may not be enough.
Can you guarantee that all your third graders will be reading at the end of the year?
No, I cannot guarantee that. I really can't.
How comfortable are you giving us a guarantee that the kids will be reading by the end of the year?
I'm somewhat confident.
Somewhat
is not a guarantee.
I have a lot of different strategies that I use to help a child learn to read. There's issues, though, like absenteeism. A child never being exposed to print. A child who only comes to school maybe 20 days in the kindergarten, 20 days in first grade, and then they come to me as a second grade. I think teachers in general have so many uncontrollable issues.
Go.
Adding to the challenge is a shortage of seats in preschool.
Dog.
It's been proven to lay the foundation for reading.
What's the dog say?
But Ohio only provides free preschool for about 6,000 children, leaving an estimated 20,000 others without. Back in third grade, students needing help may have to wait in line to see the new reading specialists. In many schools, there's one for hundreds of students.
I did the math. and the reading specialist can meet with each child individually once every 18 days.
Not enough. Absolutely not enough.
For some students, the reading guarantee has had harmful consequences. Last year, when 6 and 7-year-old Kalia and Kianesty Williams of Cincinnati were struggling in school, the district sent a tutor to their home twice a week for 2-hour sessions.
The tutor, she taught with fun, excitement, joy.
There you go.
Grandparents Daryl and Pamela Rice are raising the girls.
I noticed that they start liking to go to school. They start asking for the homework. They wanted to do the homework. It was a challenge, and they went for it.
But with the guarantee came problems for the girls. Backed by $13 million from the state, about $6,000 per school, the guarantee wouldn't begin to cover salaries for reading specialists. The state found the funds by eliminating tutoring for the Williams girls and thousands of other students.
And I said, you can't be real. If I could afford it myself, I would have paid for it because I thought it was a big help.
One of the concerns we have is that not all of that tutoring that people are receiving has been beneficial.
Following a recommendation from Ohio's Department of Education, Senator Lehner supported repurposing the tutoring funds. But, she says, it's a mistake to think that's all the money schools will need to meet the guarantee.
I'm hoping that we can put some additional money in.
How much is it going to take?
I think, frankly, we might be looking at $50, $60 million.
Lehner also acknowledges educators' other concerns about the reading guarantee, lack of preschool, and parents who don't do their part.
There's so many questions around this.
Sure.
Do you ever feel like you're stepping out on a limb on this one?
It is a risk. And I think we have to take a risk. We have to change what we're doing because what we've been doing is not working.
Can you give us a guarantee that this will work?
Of course not. Of course not.
One thing does appear guaranteed. For better or worse, children will be held back.
The research shows that if you retain children over, it does not help them down the line because they're just getting older in the grade, and then eventually they'll get in high school and they'll just drop out. Who wants to be 17 in ninth grade? Nobody.
I understand that, and I certainly hear it. The flip side of that, however, is we also know that children who are not reading proficiently in third grade are 4 times more likely to drop out in high school.
Evidence that holding those students back may be the answer comes from a recent study of Florida, where a third grade guarantee has been in place for years.
What they have seen is there have been significant improvements academically in the children who were retained from their peers who moved on. And that has held for up to 5 years.
Look in this paragraph.
But Florida spent heavily on interventions, including summer school. Ohio hasn't.
Man.
Betting the threat of holding students back will be enough to guarantee that all third graders will learn to read.